Yes. Okay, now we share with illustration and pictures, and asking questions is very important. Okay, like for instance, I gave an example. Three students went into a coffee shop. Three students went into a coffee shop and they had roti prata and teh tarik. When they finished, the waiter says, it costs each of you $10. They say, how come so expensive? Fixed price, so they each paid $10. The shop owner says, these are students, can return them by $3, $5 for all three. Waiter says, $5, I can't divide among three students. I'll keep $2 as tip, I'll return them back each $1. So each paid $10, got back $1, they paid $27, right? $30 minus three is $27. Waiter kept $2, $29. What happened to the last $1? Wrong accounting. Cindy is laughing. Okay, we confuse them. Don't give them the answer, it's wrong accounting. Okay, because the $25 you add, the $2, $27 equals $27. Okay? Then ask them, do you have a date of birth? They think it's an unriddle. It says, of course I have a date of birth. How did you get your date of birth? He said, the day my mother birthed me. I said, do you realize that your birth date was dated from the birth of Jesus? Why is your birth date dated from the birth of Jesus? Because he must be the most important person in history. You see, God created the world 4,000 years before Christ, 4,000 BC, Adam, 2,000 years was Abraham, 500 should be closer to the other side, okay? It should be Buddha, okay? David was 1,000 years before Christ, Muhammad 570 years after Christ, Lee Kuan Yew 1923 years after Christ, and you are 1980 years after Christ. How come our birth date is dated before him and after him? Because he is the God of history. In the beginning, when God created us perfect. We were sinless. We were created to live eternally. There was no death. There was no sickness. There was no pain, no suffering. You know? And God created us to have relationship with him. But there were two trees in the garden. God gave only one command. Don't take the fruit from the tree of knowledge of good and evil. There was a tree of life, and there was a tree of knowledge of good and evil in the center of the garden. But the devil came. The devil is a trickster. The devil is a deceiver. He's a thief. He came and deceived Eve and told Eve, did not God say that you should not take of this fruit? Eve said yes. The reason God asked you not to take it is because God don't want you to be like God. God don't want you to be like him. That's why he's hiding from you. He's afraid that you take this fruit. Eve saw the fruit, it was good. It looks delicious, and Eve ate it. Adam, the Bible says Adam was next to Eve, and Adam could have stopped it, said no, because the command was given to Adam. He's the head of the house. God told him, don't eat of the tree. And Adam could have stopped Eve, but Adam ate the fruit also. And therefore, sin came, separation came, disobedience came, death came, and man no longer had a relationship with God. So that's where the world is fallen. But 2,000 years ago, Jesus Christ came to live the sinless life. His sinless life canceled the sin of Adam, broke the curse of Adam. The curse is broken. We can have blessing. We can have eternal life. We can have reconciliation. We can have relationship. We can have eternity. We can have forgiveness. We can now become sons and daughters of God. And Jesus Christ is coming back again as the King of Kings, Lord of Lords, and the Savior of the world. You believe in him, you'll be part of the family of God. Amen.